channel. I hope you're having a fantastic day. Today's video, I'm going to be sharing some tips with you all on how you can save money on a trip to Switzerland. This is a very, very expensive country. I lived almost 5 years in this country, so I know it is very, very expensive, and it's definitely tough if you are on a super, super tight budget. But this is a super amazing country, and I definitely think everybody should come and see it. So I wanted to make this video to share with you all some ways that you can save. I see tourists making very expensive mistakes all the time, and I just thought I want to make this video and help you all save some money if you are planning on coming here. Let's get straight into it. Okay, guys, first thing, avoid taxis, cabs at all costs. They are extremely, extremely expensive. I haven't taken a cab here in a long time, but I'm pretty sure just to sit down is 7 or 8 Swiss francs. So very expensive. Just to go 10 minutes, I mean, can cost you upwards of 30 Swiss francs. So definitely avoid taxis at all costs, but don't worry, you have a lot of other options. The public transportation here is absolutely fantastic. You can take a bus, a tram, a train, a boat, all sorts of things. But if you just walk up to the ticket counter and buy a ticket for one of those public transportations, they're very expensive as well. Most Swiss people have a card that gives them 50% off, so the regular prices are really just reserved for the tourists, and it is very expensive. So you have two options to save on public transportation here. The first one, if you are a planner, this is the way to go. Before you leave your country where you live, you need to go online and order a Eurorail pass if you do not live in Europe. And if you do live in Europe, it is called an Interrail pass. So you can buy a one country pass, and it covers the whole of Switzerland, and you can travel around for much, much cheaper anyways. You can check out those websites if you're interested in that, but that's what you're looking for. Eurorail if you are not European, Interrail if you are European. You will not regret it. You will save so much money on transportation. They are kind of expensive, but trust me, you're going to save, I would say, yeah, a good amount of money. So definitely worth it. I still buy these when I come and visit. But you do have to order those before you leave your country, and they still ship them like mailbox, post, paper, so you have to be a little bit, you know, on it. So getting those passes requires a little bit of forethought, but if you didn't do it, don't worry, I have another option for you. So if you arrive in Switzerland and you didn't have time to pre-order a pass, you want to go on the Swiss train transportation website. It is called SBB, and really hidden there is a tab called Super Saver Tickets where you can look for discounted fares, and sometimes they're up to 50% off. Downside with these is you need to know exactly what train you are taking, whereas if you buy a normal ticket, you can take any train from the start point to the end point, but with the Super Saver, you have to say this train at this time. Usually they are more the off peak times. But again, if you're here as a tourist, it's probably something that will really work for you. You can check it online, and they also have an app. I'll put in some screenshots, so definitely look into that. But I definitely recommend the Interrail, Eurorail if you are planning. Also be aware, I do not believe they really have Uber in Switzerland, not Uber the way that most of us know it, with just like, you know, drivers. You know, I think it is somehow tied into the taxi thing and regulated, and you're not gonna be able to find cheap Ubers as well, so that's not gonna work. Okay, next way to save is also related to transportation. A lot of cities have free bike rental programs, so you're gonna have to pay a deposit of, I don't know, 20 Swiss francs or so, but you can take a bike for free and use it all day long, so this is a great way to save. Switzerland is a great country for biking. They have great bike lanes, and it's not too crowded on the streets typically, so yeah, definitely check if the cities that you're visiting have this free bike rental program. I know there was one in Zurich where we used to live, and yeah, it was a $20 deposit, and you can bike all day, and just you have to bring it back at the end of the night, or you do get charged like an overnight fee. Next way to save, and I hate to say it, it's kind of sad, but you're gonna have to avoid restaurants at all costs. Eating out here is very, very expensive, and when I say very expensive, you can expect to pay for a plate of literally spaghetti with red sauce, not even like a bolognese sauce, just spaghetti and red sauce, $18 to $22 Swiss francs. So it's extremely, extremely expensive to go out to eat here, and you don't have free water or anything. So if you want to just get spaghetti, red sauce, and a water, you can expect to spend upwards of $30, which can be really, really painful if you are on a budget. But don't worry, there are all sorts of grocery stores around. This is what I like to do. You can go to the grocery store, pick yourself up some fruit, a sandwich, whatever, go sit by the lake and enjoy the view and just eat like that. Sometimes it stinks because there are so many gorgeous restaurants in this country. I just want to go and see and experience all of them, but it is not very budget friendly at all. So make sure you find a grocery store close to where you are staying and just eat out of there for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It's a bit of a pain, but you can save a lot. And also note the grocery stores, they're sometimes kind of hard to find because they're sometimes downstairs under a shopping mall or in weird locations. So just don't be scared to ask somebody where the nearest grocery store is. By the way, this applies to bars and going out for drinks as well. Cocktails can be very, very expensive. Upwards of $20 Swiss francs for a cocktail. I know, guys, it sounds crazy, but if you're in a nice hotel or something, you can expect to pay, yeah, I would say $15 to $20 for a cocktail and anywhere between $6 and $12, $13 for a glass of wine. So it can be very, very expensive. But again, in Switzerland, you can buy your beer, your wine, your whatever. You can go drink it by the lake, go find somewhere. It's completely legal to drink openly in public in this country, so you won't have any problems there. And this is actually really nice. There's always a lot of benches around and nice places with beautiful views, so this is definitely what I recommend. Next item that you can save on is accommodation. Hotels are, you guessed it, also quite expensive here. Hostels are pretty affordable, but if you're not really into that, what I recommend is you get an Airbnb. I've stayed in so many fantastic Airbnbs in Switzerland. So many insanely beautiful Airbnbs with amazing views, great hosts. I've had so many good experiences here. I can definitely recommend it. I do have a link in the description to save, I think, between $20 and $50 on your first Airbnb. So you can click on that and check it out if you're interested in Airbnb. But I definitely use it every time we travel here. And then also the bonus is not only do you save on accommodation, then you also can access a kitchen so you can cook and you can save on food. It's really great, and bonus points if you can find a place that has a washing machine and you can do your laundry as well. Love Airbnb, especially in Switzerland. So many beautiful, beautiful places. So definitely do that. Next way you can save, it's not a huge savings, but something you might want to consider is in Switzerland, toilets are not really free. If you go to the Tramain train station, here in Lucerne where I am right now, it is $2 to go to the bathroom, which isn't a big deal. I have to say I do pay it because it is a quite nice service. The toilets are really, really clean. They clean them after every single person. So for me, it is, I think it's worth it, and I do pay it, believe it or not. But I can imagine if you're a family of six or so, that could be a very expensive bathroom break. So try to figure out where the closest free toilets are to where you are staying or where you're going to be. There might even be some apps for this, or you can find some articles perhaps on a tourism website. I think I've seen something for Lucerne called like Friendly Toilets or something with restaurants and places that have agreed to let tourists use their bathrooms. So just maybe if you have a big family, it's something to look into because you don't want to get stuck spending $12 on a bathroom break. That would kind of be painful. So just something to keep in mind. And if you do want to use one of those public toilets, make sure that you have coins with you because you're going to need those all the time. Another small way that you can save is in Switzerland, there are drinking fountains all over the city. So if you carry a water bottle with you, you can fill it up at one of these fountains and you won't have to go and spend, you know, $4 on a water bottle from a kiosk or something like that. So they look kind of funny. I'll put in some clips here, but these are drinkable water. These are not water fountains for decoration. You can drink this water. Everybody drinks it. The locals drink it. It's good. So yeah, another way that you can save a bit. So just bring a water bottle with you and fill it up as you go. They're all over the town and they're not that hard to find. So just a little tip. Okay, last tip kind of ties back into the grocery store thing I was talking about. But when you are going grocery shopping, make sure that you are at a normal grocery store. So the ones that Swiss people shop at are called Migro, Coop, and they even have Aldi now. So if you see like something that's like a small next to the train station, this is probably going to be really expensive compared to where the locals shop, which is Migro, Coop, and sometimes Aldi. So you might want to map out and make sure that you are at one of those three stores. If you're at some small convenience type of store, it can be extremely marked up. So make sure you're at one of those. And second, you can look for 50% off labels. I see these all the time in Switzerland. I think if you go close to closing time, you can find all sorts of fruits and vegetables and sandwiches marked 50%. So definitely look for that label and you can save a good amount of money because even little wraps and sandwiches can be pretty expensive here. So check for the 50% off ones. If you can find them, it's a great savings. That is it. I hope you found some of these tips helpful or useful in some way. If you want to hear more videos about Switzerland, comment down below what you would like to see. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you very soon in the next video. Bye!
And until next time, guys, don't forget, every single day you have the opportunity to take your dreams and put them into action. So work hard, be kind, make it happen.